Hey guys, welcome back to another exciting tutorial of creating process, and it is making this on the three-dimensional edgy logo design. The logo is formed from basic shape of alphabet O. On the surface there are very sharp cutted edgy structure like crystal where few edgy shapes are joined together. So to design this logo, we'll first create all the basic shape using the rectangle tool, and then with the help of line segment tool and the shape builder tool, we'll create all these each separate shapes. And then we'll add up the gradient color in the proper order, and then finally we'll add up text. So let's begin the tutorial. So to design, we'll select the rectangle tool and right click your mouse button. Here, keep the width around 100 and height around 200 and click OK. So we create a rectangle of 100 by 200. Now next, we'll convert this into stroke color. Then after that, we'll increase the stroke thickness to around, let's check it out. Just scroll your mouse and you'll see the change like that. So we'll keep this around 55. Let's check it out. If I keep it around 55, okay, that's fine. So once you're given the stroke thickness, we'll go to object, path, and outline stroke. And this will convert this into object form. Now next thing is we'll add a few points to this shape. So with the help of pen tool, we'll add up the points. So we need around one around here. Like if you click here, the points get added. In the same way, we'll need one around here. This one is good. We need one around here. I'll add one here. I'll add one here. I'll add one around here for this corner. And for this, we have it. Now next thing, so with the direct selection tool, I'll select this points and just drag it down, or one, or just place it independently with your hand. So I'll just select this and drag around here, like maintaining the shape. This one, I'll just push it up and place it around here. This one, we'll select it and just drag it down. This one, just push it up a little bit. This one on top like this, pushing it outside like that. So we'll be maintaining the shape like this. This one a little bit downward. This one a little bit like this. This one a little bit top, and this one more top. Like so, doing the placement is important. So I'll just select this and push it a little bit inside, and this one push it a little bit outside like that. This one I'll just push it down like here. So once you have got a basic shape, the next thing is to create these separate shapes. So to create that, we'll use the line segment tool. I'll select the line segment and change the color to black, so that I can see it. Now after that, I'll just draw a few line segments. So from this point, click and drag till this point. So from this point, click and drag till this point. From here, click and drag till this point. Okay, you can undo that if its position get fluctuated. So click and drag and until this point. The same way, I will do one more. We'll have to add few here. So I'll just click one around here and just make it attached here like that, and one from here till here, and you can see one is down here. So I'll just click from here and one, place it around here like that. So that's way. Once you've done that, we'll do from here also. I'll just click and drag and attach to this point, click, and we'll give a band here. So I'll leave it one around here and one from this point till this point, connecting this. And next, we'll from one till here, again from here, connecting this point, and one from this point, connecting, not connecting, giving it a space here and intersecting, and give it here. And same way, one from here and connecting this point. So once you have arranged all the line segment in the proper place, and we need one more here, so I'll just select the line segment, and you can see that there are some depth. So I'll use the line segment and draw it out like this till here. Now I'll select everything, and with the shape builder tool, we'll just break out each shape. So I'll select the shape builder tool and give it some color, like just change the color to black. And give it some different color, like if I go here and here. So I'll just select this and click here. So we are giving different colors to the different shapes so that we can easily select each piece separately. So I'm just going in and changing the color and just clicking over there, just giving it different color tones like that. I'll select here, this, select this, change the color and just give it different color. Select this, change the color, just giving different color with the shape editor tool, and it will automatically separate those shapes independently, and you can edit it later on with the gradient color. So we are doing that, and I'll just change the color to this. To this, we need a few more shapes, so I'll just do different colors from here, add here, choose different color from here like green, add one around here, a little bit different colors, one here from different color, so we'll choose like yellow from here. I think these colors are matching each other. I'll just change the colors to this, a little bit different colors, giving it a little bit yellow. Now selecting this color, selected orange, and this. So we have given all the different shape with different colors. Now the next thing is, you can see you have got that shape and we have got each shape separately. Next thing is, I'll just remove the outline color. So I'll just go here and remove the outlines. And now let's select independently. Now next thing is, we'll add up the gradient color. So we have got the color palette here. We'll use this and fill up with that. So I'll select this with a V for selection and I for eye picker. And with the Alt and Shift press, I'll just select this color. In the same way, selection tool, select this object. With eye picker, select the color like this. Okay, selection tool, select this object. With the eye picker, select this color. Selection tool, select this object. With the eye picker, select this color. V for selection, I'll select this one small piece and we'll fill this up with dark color. Now select this, and you can see this is lighter one. I need select this, and I'll fill this up with this color, lighter one. In the same way, I'll select this with the eye picker, select this darker one. Select this small piece with the eye picker, select the same color. We need the same color here. Now select this with the eye picker, select this color. Select this with the eye picker, they both have the same color, so we'll apply that. Select this with the eye picker, we'll apply this dark color for here. Select this one with the eye picker. Select this light color, and this is for this color. And for last piece, select this one with eye picker. Here's the last piece. So now we have added up all the gradient colors. Still it's not looking good because we haven't adjusted gradient color. So we have to select each individual pieces, and with the color selected, we'll edit the gradient color. So with the gradient color, G for gradient tool, just click and drag and adjust the colors like that. Now V for selection, select the object, G for gradient, and apply the gradient color in the proper order like this. So we need from dark around here and lighter downward. In the same way, select this G and like this, select this G, dark to light, select this G, dark to light, or maybe in the opposite way. Okay, in this way, you can see that it's looking good. You can give little contrast by changing the gradient color, like going in here and just reducing the gradient length, and you can see it's now lighter here there. In the same way, I select this, zoom it in, G for gradient, and just change the colors. And this one, select this, G, and from here till dark. Or maybe we are in the opposite direction, like this. So we need dark here, lighter there. You can see that. And in the same way, we'll select this, and here we'll do the opposite way, G, and here we need dark and lighter there. So we'll apply that. Now select this, V for selection, G for gradient, and darker to lighter. We can give a little extension, this much. This one, select this, G, darker to lighter, but giving it a little contrast like that. We can see that contrast here. Select this, G, darker to lighter, or maybe from darker downward to lighter like that. In the same way, select this, G, give it the gradient color. In the same way, select the final object with a V, G for gradient, and you can see the change. Just drag and apply it like this. And finally, we have added all the gradient colors in the proper places. You can see, and now let's do the adjustment, little fold adjustment. So we'll do that by using the direct selection tool and selecting the points like that with a shift, deselect this, and we can move the arrow keys, and you can see that the points are moving. So do the adjustment here if you need, and select this. We'll just push it down a little bit, moving it this side, making it a little bit shapy. This one we need to extend a little bit outside. If you want to change this one also, just select it, deselect this, and just move it a little bit this side like that. You can do the adjustment here, select this, move ups and down, or maybe right and left. This one, if you want to extend it, extend it. This one, we need to push it a little bit outside or a little bit downward. You can do that, select this, downward and a little bit outside, and this one more outside. So in this way you can maintain the shape by individually selecting the shapes and maintaining it. You can give a little twist over here also by selecting the edges. So finally we have added the gradient color. Now the last thing we are left with is text. So I'll use the T for text, type out the alphabet, that's argon, O-R-G-A-N, argon, and we'll apply the font, which is TWCANMT. So if you go here, you can see that we are applying this one, TWCANMT, and the font is regular. So we have chosen that, and with the RP color, I'll just select this, and the color, we're selecting this color. Okay, now after that we have given that color too. So now we have applied the colors, and now let's do a little adjustment. Go to characters, and let's give some distance around 1500. Let's check it out. Okay, let's place it there, or maybe let's reduce it a little bit around 1000, and let's reduce the icon or logo size to around a little bit lesser, and place it there, and let's place the text. So this is really good. So this is the edgy logo design which we have created, the step-by-step process, and we have learned few more techniques here. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more advice on designing, you can press the subscribe button. For business inquiry, you can check out the link on the screen, and you also find it on description below. Thank you.